History. Last known sighting, near Buenos Aires, Argentina, 2003. As one of their interests, or area of study, to see how other races react to tragedies and cataclysms. One alien race reported that they, the Tanzanians, caused both crashing of the Hindenburg, as well as the sinking of Titanic. They are of Tanzania. They come from constellation Perseus, near the star Gorgonia Secunda. They can live up to 500 years and are around 1.7 meters tall. Technologically, they are extremely advanced. They have caused thousands, maybe millions of deaths on Earth and other planets, as one of their interests, or area of study, to see how other races react to tragedies and cataclysms. One alien race reported that they, the Tanzanians, caused both crashing of the Hindenburg, as well as the sinking of Titanic. They are avoided by other races. Last sighting, January 1999, in New York. Tolosian. Tall, blonde inhabitants of a re-established network of subsurface antediluvian colonies located throughout the western states and concentrated around Mount Shasta in northern California. They are sometimes referred to erroneously as Lemurians, as it is believed that the cavern cities which they rediscovered and built upon were once part of an antediluvian civilization called Lemuria, Elamu. They may have loose contact with the Pleiadians and other groups via ancient ancestral ties, since the Tolosians are Earth natives who allegedly possess interstellar vehicles and are a western branch of the sub-international Agati network and its silver fleet. The name Telos is a Greek word meaning uttermost or purpose, yet some of the inhabitants refer to ancient ties with Neo-Mayan tribes, and therefore many of them may possess a Greco-Mayan ancestry. Some ancient Vedic texts speak of a collaboration between the Greeks and the East Indians, who some believe gave rise to the Mayas, in the development and construction of aerial craft called Vimanas. Tolosians are part of a Melchizedek spiritual order with connections to the Ashtar collective mind, and have dealings with extraterrestrials in Arcturus, Sirius, and Saturn, as well as with other dimensional beings. The Taros. Taros, which is short from integrative or constructive, are a subsurface race that usually keep the Taros in check. The Taros were the original tribe of the Lunarians, who came to this planet to dwell beneath the surface of the Earth. They are referred to as the Sunanans, meaning the yearly ones. The Taros were for disagreeable people, and the Taros were for agreeable people. Their chief is named Lamza. The Taros came from the planet Jomon, in the star constellation Arcturus, which is in the Boots constellation. Arcturus, the red giant, the fourth brightest star in heaven, is where much mixing took place. The Sunanans have 48 chromosomes instead of the normal 46 that Earth people possess. The Taros' chromosome structure is so different from Earthlings that when mixed with certain humans, it caused a defect of 47 chromosomes, which today is called Down's syndrome. Their children are usually born with breathing defects, as well as congenital heart disease, and they also have poor digestive systems. Their immune system is unable to function properly, and they are more prone to developing leukemia. The Taros that have an abundance of pigmentation in their skin are descendants of the Shuyuk. Those who are lacking pigmentation are descendants of the Halobeans, Flagellords or Hulub. The Taros bored further into the earth, and were able to keep their sanity. Because of crossbreeding, the Taros took on different forms. Some look so human they can come to the surface and not be noticed. Most of the legends of leprechauns and trolls derive from this species. The Umites. Humans claiming to hail from the general area of Wolf 424, some 14 plus light years distant from the Earth's Sol system, and possibly having ancient ties with the Lyran colonies, in that the Umites from the planet Umo are like the Lyrans Pleiadians, said to be Scandinavian in appearance, and therefore may tie in with the so-called Nordic or Blonde societies. They reportedly work closely with the vegan humanoids. Vegans. Relatively peaceful and gentle humans, descended from refugees from the Lyran Wars, who work closely with other refugee colonists, now living in the Pleiades, Wolf 424, and elsewhere. Often described as dark-skinned Orientals, similar to the native residents of the nation of India. Vega was one of the first Lyran civilizations to develop a unique and cohesive identity, which assisted in seeding and colonizing many systems, including Altair, Centauri, Sirius and Orion. Physical characteristics of the Vegans. A. Standard vegan, 6 to 7 feet tall, darker skin, sometimes copper-toned, non-Caucasian, black hair, very large eyes with dark pupil and iris, and one lid. Blood is green. B. Non-human type vegans, humanoid or mammal, yet their appearance is more insect-like or reptilian. Their skin is dark, sometimes even with a green or brownish tinge. Venusians. There are many stories about inhabitants of Venus. Surface colonies allegedly exist in biodome cities, whereas still other reportedly live in the antimatter, counterpart of Venus, which in the alternate universe is part of a 12-planet alliance, called the Cold Asian Alliance according to some contactees. The Pleiadians also claim to have colonized the antimatter universe, which they call the Dull Universe. One of these races that are said to live on Venus are the Hatha, mentioned by Bob Frisl. They are a fourth-dimensional race. Another race of Venusian origin is mentioned by Dr. Daniel Fry in the White Sands Incident. The Gnors are said to be an etheric higher-dimensional race. When they choose to take physical shape, they look like Earth's Nordic races. They supposedly are one of the eldest races in our solar system, and are members of the Galactic Council. The Gnors no longer inhabit Venus. Vinivori. They come from constellation Pavo, and are vegetarians. They are a very respected and peaceful race, presumably with mystical powers. They have come to Earth at least since 1000 AD. They can live up to 2000 years. Their height is similar to that of a normal human. Last sighting, near Odessa, Ukraine in July of 1995. Zeta Reticuli, aka Shambhala. Often confused, because of their appearance, with the races Maitre and Solipsirei, the Greys. They come from constellation Nets. They are allies of the Anunnaki, and cooperate with them on different planets. They are representatives of the Anunnaki on Earth, and send them information about humans and this planet, at least 25 times per year. The Anunnaki created a subspecies of the Zeta, with the purpose of making them look more human-like, but leaving enough physical differences for humans to distinguish them. They became some of the pharaohs of Egypt. The most well-known was Akhenaten, who was removed from power by reptilians. They infiltrated themselves in the court as temple priests. First reports of Zetas on Earth go back to 4000 AD. But that number is most likely higher. They were the first hybrids to be engineered by the Anunnaki. The Zeta subspecies still exist on Earth and still, at least 30% present the same physical differences created in them. The sexual organs of the subspecies are in every aspect, the same as that of humans. Their Zetas still exist on Earth in both forms. The original and the hybrid subspecies. Their location on Earth is unknown.
Can you feel it? A sort of anticipation growing stronger and stronger? Another way of putting it is time is speeding up. I've heard that discussion for a while now. I know most people have felt it at some point, maybe while watching the news or perhaps something in their own lives. Something big is about to happen.